In this lecture, I will try to cover some aspects which help you enhance your speed in solving some of the problems, because in competition, time is the essence. So some formulas which I'll tell you, which you might be knowing, are generally not found in books, will help you. Now, for example, if I take a situation where this is a wedge, angle theta is same, and these are two objects, both have same mass and same radius. It's a solid cylinder, it's a hollow cylinder, tube-like. Here it's a solid cylinder, it's a hollow cylinder. If I ask you in which arrangement the contact will not be broken, so immediately you should know the contact will not be broken in case the object which is ahead has a lesser acceleration. If you start from initially, they are at rest, both of them are rest, it is left. So the contact will not be broken if the one which is ahead has a lower acceleration, because otherwise if the one which is ahead has a faster acceleration, will move ahead, and the one which is behind will keep on coming, contact will be broken. For contact not to be broken, the one which is ahead should determine the acceleration, means its acceleration should be less. Now immediately you should know which one has, with same radius, same mass, which one has greater acceleration. And the formula which I suggest here is A is equal to G sine theta upon 1 plus C. And C is something which is very easy to remember. Let me take the ring, disc, solid sphere, and hollow sphere. For ring, the moment of inertia is mr square. For disk, it is half mr square. For solid sphere, it is 2.5 mr square. And for hollow sphere, it is 2 upon 3 mr square. So what I am doing is, I am just taking this coefficient as c. Here c is 1. Here c is 1 upon 2. Here c is 2 upon 5. And here c is 2 upon 3. And this is the value which I put here, and immediately you will get the acceleration. I will also derive this, how it has come. I'll spend some time in deriving it. So just in case of a disc cylinder which is solid and hollow, the difference will be, let me take solid. So it is G sine theta. In case of solid, which one I am going to use? The one which is for disc, C is 1 upon 2. So it is 1 plus 1 upon 2. So it is 3 upon 2, so 2. This is 2g sine theta upon 3. Now let me take acceleration of the hollow one, hollow cylinder. It is g sine theta, 1 plus c. And what is c? In case of hollow, it's like a ring kind of a structure. Here it is mr square, c is 1, so it is 1. So it is g sine theta upon 2. Which one is lesser? A hollow is lesser than A solid. So A hollow is lesser than A solid. If you place the hollow cylinder first, only then the contact will not be broken. If you place the hollow cylinder here, then the contact will be broken, because the acceleration of the hollow has to be low, and the acceleration of solid is more than the acceleration of hollow here. So now how this basic formula has come. For pure rolling down the inclined plane, let us take a general case. This is a general case where this is mg sine theta is downwards force. This is, and this is normal reaction N, and this is mg cos theta. And here we are taking a case where we leave the body initially at rest. This is the case which we are taking, and we want pure rolling to take place. Now, when the body starts rolling, pure rolling starts, you need friction force in the backward direction, otherwise it will not get omega. It has to get a torque, and torque will be given by this friction force. So this friction force will also oppose the downward motion. So for downward motion, the equation is ma is equal to mg sine theta minus f, or a is equal to g sine theta minus f upon m. And let me write the formula for the torque. Torque is equal to I alpha, and here torque is equal to F into R. And for I, let me write a general formula, C times MR square, C times MR square into alpha. So alpha R is F upon CM is my alpha R. For pure rolling to happen, and one more important point, here the value of F should never be put as mu mg cos theta, because this is the maximum value which is available. And here it's a pure rolling, it doesn't use the maximum frictional force, only use F. And F here is actually the mu minimum which is required, mu minimum g cos theta into m. This is the frictional coefficient based on the frictional coefficient of the body, which is mu, means this is the maximum friction this body can provide. But here it doesn't use the maximum friction, it uses F, which is required for this pure rolling movement down the plane. So never use this formula in case of pure rolling up the inclined plane or down the inclined plane, only use F, because F here is mu minimum g cos theta into m. Now let me put this value here. So A is equal to R alpha, because it's a pure rolling case. So F upon CM is equal to G sine theta minus F upon M. So F upon M 1 plus 1 upon C is equal to G sine theta. So my F upon M is G sine theta 1 plus 1 upon C is my F. Now what is my acceleration? Acceleration is G sine theta minus F upon M, which is G sine theta 1 plus 1 upon C. So it becomes G sine theta, you take common, 1 plus 1 upon C minus 1 upon 1 plus C, 1 upon 1 plus C. So it comes as, this gets cancelled, it A comes as G sine theta upon C plus 1. This is the value of acceleration which I was mentioning, where C is nothing but the coefficient multiplied to the MR square. And you have for the rotational dynamics, you have standard moment of inertia formula. So just remember this formula and put the coefficient which is multiplied with MR square, you can immediately get the value of A. Now suppose the question is, you have to find the minimum frictional force required for each of the bodies. And for that the formula comes in a similar way. The formula is mu minimum is equal to tan theta upon 1 plus 1 upon C. And let me show you how it has come. It's very simple. We have found the value of F upon M, and we want minimum value of F. Put the minimum value of F which is required, mu minimum g cos theta into M. MM will get cancelled, is equal to g sine theta 1 plus 1 upon C. So mu minimum is equal to tan theta into 1 plus 1 upon C. So from this general formula, these two are general formulas, you can immediately find the mu minimum required of the frictional force. If the problem is that different bodies are given and you have to tell what is the minimum frictional force which this inclined plane should have, so that all the cylinder, the sphere, the shell, the disc, all should be able to do pure rotational motion coming down the plane. What is the minimum frictional force? So you have to find the maximum of the minimum. You will find minimum of each, and whatever is maximum, you will have to use that. So, and just straight away use this formula. And another formula for increasing the speed is the rotational energy and translational energy when they are added. So when you have rotational and translational motion, you generally write both half mv square plus half I omega square. So many times what happens, there's a mistake in doing it. So to save the time, the best formula is half mv square into 1 plus c. Here c is again same. And you can easily find out how c has come. If I use this formula, half mv square plus half I is what c mr square. And omega is what v square upon r square. So half mv square plus half c m v square. This r is getting cancelled, so it is half mv square into 1 plus c. Nothing great about this formula, but it fastens your speed. Like in case of if you are dealing with solid sphere, you can immediately write 1 plus 2 upon 5, that is 7 upon 5, you can write into half mv square. But don't forget to put this half is still there. Only thing is 1 plus c is added with this, multiplied with this half. So these are some tips how to solve, how to enhance the speed, and also try to solve this problem. So you need this condition, hollow has to be ahead, because acceleration of hollow is lower than acceleration of solid. Try to find out what will be the acceleration if the friction between them is mu, and nothing else is given, and it's a pure ruling case.